In this video, we're going to talk about some of the wireless Echoflex control products. I've got a number here. Some of them are dimming lighting controllers, and some of them are switching controllers. Starting on my left is our newest product, the ELED1. It is a 0 to 10 volt controller. Its power supply is versatile, going from 120 all the way through to 277 volts. It is a power pack style that I've got here, but it comes also in a strap mount model for use inside fixtures. It is a UL924 listed device and is applicable for emergency lighting fixtures as well. Next one in line is the ERDRC-FD or FC. It is also a power pack style 0 to 10 volt dimming controller. It has a 20 amp relay in it. The ELED1 has an 11.5 amp relay. So this guy is applicable for full circuit control. Available with 120, 277, or 347 volt for Canadian applications. The next one in line here is our phase dimmer, the ER6CD. It is a phase adaptive dimmer, which means that it can support reverse and forward phase dimming. It will support up to 600 watts of dimming. It's also a power pack style. All of these power packs are plenum rated. You see the half inch nipple for mounting there on conduit. Moving over to my right, this is a low voltage version of our switching relay, the ERM model, and this is the 24 volt version. It also comes as a 120 through 277 volt version. It has a dry contact output and is excellent for HVAC integration applications where you want to be able to take your lighting occupancy sensors, your wireless sensors, and link them into your HVAC system. This device will be powered off of the 24 volt from the HVAC controller, and the dry contact can be wired in to one of the inputs for occupancy state for the HVAC controllers. And lastly, here is our receptacle, controlled receptacle. It is a 15 amp controlled receptacle. It is split, so the top half is not controlled and the bottom half is controlled. We also have a red auxiliary wire here for connecting other non-controlled receptacles downstream so you can control more than one receptacle. All of these products have a similar interface. They all support telegram repeating. They all support status transmission, which means that they will transmit status of their relay and their dimming state if it's a dimming controller. These can all be activated through the hardware interface, which we'll talk about next. The interface on the hardware is identical as well. We have a set of buttons and we have a set of LEDs. I have a power LED, I have a learn LED, I have a learn button, and I have a clear button. So the clear button is a button that's used to reset the controller back to a factory default state. It can also be used to reset the controller back to a pre-commissioned state if desirable. So the learn button is what we use to link devices together. I need to put my controller into learn mode by pressing this button in. It's going to cycle its relay and going to raise and lower the lights. The learn LED will be on solid green. The red LED will be blinking at the same rate as the relay is blinking. After you've exited learn mode by pressing the learn button again, the red power LED will blink a pattern telling you what you have linked to the device and how many of that device you have linked. Check the install guides for more about these blink codes. The last thing I want to draw your attention to is the orange wire that is visible on some of the products. This is the antenna wire, and it should not be tampered with. You don't want to be cutting or putting a wire on this wire. For more information about these products and any of the other Echoflex products and the services that we provide, please visit our website at echoflexsolutions.com.